In this video, we're going to find the equation of the line that goes through the point 1, 4, and 7, 12. So we're going to be looking for a linear function between these two points. Now, remember, we have point slope form of a linear function, which looks like y equals mx plus b. So the first thing we're going to want to do is find the slope. M represents the slope in this form. And one easy way of remembering M is it's change in y over change in x, or change in outputs over change in inputs. Now, oftentimes in mathematics, we use the symbol delta to denote change. So that's what I'm doing here by using this triangle. It's the Greek letter delta. So we need to find the change in those. And so what that means is we need to look at the outputs and look at their change. So there's our two outputs. So in the numerator, we're going to have 12 minus 4, because that would be the change in outputs. Now, the order doesn't necessarily matter when we're doing the numerator. All that matters is that we do the denominator in the same order. So because I did 12 minus 4, in the denominator, I want it to be 7 minus 1. Check. Here's the point 7, 12. Here's the point 1, 4. Outputs on top, inputs on bottom. All right. If you get those backwards, what you're going to have is your slope will come out to be the same magnitude, but will have a different sign. So we calculate this, and we have 12 minus 4 is equal to 8. 7 minus 1 is equal to 6. When we get a fraction, we're going to go ahead and reduce it, and I'm going to do this problem in fractions. So that reduces down to 4/3, because I can divide a 2 out of each of them. Now, we need to find the y-intercept. Well, here's what we have for our point slope form so far. Y equals 4/3 x plus, well, we don't know b yet. So I'm going to just represent it with b. What I'm going to do is I'm going to plug in a point for x and y to solve for b, and this will always work. This works really nice when we have decimals or fractions. I'm going to go ahead and pick my first point here. So I know that y equals 4 when x equals 1, and I now have enough information to solve for b. So I get 4 equals 4/3 times 1 is just 4/3 plus b. I'm going to subtract 4/3 off of both sides, because those will cancel. It might be easier to do this in terms of thirds. So 4 is actually 12/3. That equals 8/3, and there is our b. So our linear function is y equals 4/3 x plus 8/3. And we have it there in point slope form.